Genesis chapter 41. Amen. I've heard what Elijah telling you that you must sing. I think I've told you the same thing. I'm always telling you that. You know, Sunday school, I'm always telling you that Sunday school is yours. It's not for me, it's not for anyone, it's for you children. You understand? So, I'm trying to teach this one for you. Most of the people here, they know what I'm teaching here on Sunday school. I'm trying to do it for you. So when you come to Sunday school, you must sing. You understand? You need to sing. So don't wait for someone to tell you you have to sing on Sunday school. You must know that it's your duty to sing on Sunday school. Okay? I think next time you're going to sing loud. Amen? Okay. So let us read Genesis chapter 14. Let us read together, children. Says what?
And behold, there came forth out of the womb of Seth the number of favored kind and fast strength, and he fed in a little. And behold, Seth the other kind came up after them out of the river.
Amen. Blessed be thy wonderful name, Lord Jesus. Once more, say thank you for this wonderful time. Father, we commit ourselves to you. Come this Sunday school in your holy hands. Please come, Lord, and speak to our children as we commit them in your holy hands. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. So, who can remind me what we didn't study last time? You can tell me. Yes,
I was talking about when Joseph went to prison for
no reason. Joseph went to prison for no reason. Who else can tell me? Yes, sir.
Talking about the baker and the butler.
Yeah, the baker and the butler, right? Yeah. It's still the same, yeah. Yes, Malaysia.
When Potiphar's wife wanted to be.
Yeah. We spoke about Joseph and Potiphar's wife. Okay, thank you very much. So, Joseph became the second boss in the house of Potiphar. Yeah. As I said, Joseph could say, oh, thank God, I've got a nice job. I was a stranger in this land, but now I'm the second boss in the house of Potiphar. For Joseph, if it was only for Joseph, he could say, oh, this one is the top of my ambition. Amen. But God had something else in his mind. The road or the way to the glory didn't finish it. It wasn't the end yet. Amen. But to human understanding, we say that, oh, what are you looking for again? You are the second boss in the house of Potiphar. It's a nice job. Amen. But God knew better. For God to take him more higher, God had to take Joseph to prison again. And God designed the wife of Potiphar to do the job. Do you understand? That's the reason everything happening to you, don't complain. Amen. You say, thank God. That's the only way God planned to take Joseph to the throne of Egypt. Because a great challenge was coming. What was the challenge? The famine. The famine is going to come. People will be starving about food. And the only place where the food can come from is from Egypt. Amen. And if Joseph is not the boss in Egypt, there's no way for Israel to escape the famine. Do you understand? So God had his plan. Amen. And also, in the redemption, since Genesis, when Adam and Eve fell in Genesis, God had a plan for human being. What was the plan about? It was about take man in his position. You understand? The only way God could take man to his position, God had to become a human being. God became a man called Jesus. You understand? So God came down. But I'm saying that when God came down, he became a man. He took the form of humiliation. He made himself small. You understand? Only for the fulfillment of his plan. Amen. So when we are studying this book of Genesis, it's because I want to show you this one as the pattern to the book of redemption, how God was working. And I've told you that Joseph was a type of Jesus Christ. Amen. So Joseph was tempted by the wife of Potiphar. I said that Joseph was alone in Egypt, no child, no brothers, no sisters, alone, not even a Bible, not even a message book, alone. He was standing before that woman. Joseph said, I can't do this. Why? Because I'm a child of God. And you know the story, the woman took Joseph's garments. Amen. The woman took Joseph's garment, said, if you don't come to me, I'll scream and tell the people that you came to me. Then you know what's going to take place, because I'm the wife of Potiphar, of course. So you'll be taken and put in prison. So you must do what I'm telling you. And Joseph said, I'm sorry, I can't do it. You can scream if you want to. I know that no one is going to believe me. But God in heaven knows that I am right to my own thinking. Amen. And then she took Joseph's garments and she screamed. People came and said, what happened? So Joseph was trying to come to me. What is that, Joseph? What are you doing? And she took Joseph, put him in prison. So all Egypt, they knew that Joseph is a bad boy, as I said. Amen. And Joseph standing alone in the prison, he didn't have time, he didn't get time to go and explain, to tell the people the real story. Amen. And Joseph was sitting in the prison as an innocent person, and in all the land of Egypt, they knew that Joseph was a bad boy. Amen. And Joseph didn't care about explanation, to explain to people to know that he is innocent. He was sitting there. But Joseph had faith to God. Amen. So he knew that the same God, the one who was with me in the pit, is the same God who is with me in the prison. Amen. So Joseph could tell himself that, I know that God is preparing something for me. Amen. It's not about punishment. God wasn't punishing Joseph. No. Joseph didn't think about that because he knew that he was a righteous man. Amen. So, whatever what happened to you, amen, it's not because you're bad. It's not because maybe God is punishing you. Maybe it's not just God trying to take you somewhere. And Joseph sitting in the prison, you know, and these two people here, the burglar and the bad person, I want you to be with me. Okay? The burglar and the other, who was?
And the
baker. Both of them had dreams. I don't want to to go in detail. Who can tell the dream, their dreams? Who can tell their dreams? Tisa, what happened? Tell the dream.
The first dream was that foreign boy is coming and bright.
Thank you, Sister Wala. You see? Thank you. God bless you. He was carrying the bread and the bird came to eat the bread. And what Joseph said? Joseph said that that means he's going to be killed, isn't it? Yeah. So, what was the other dream, Sister Wala? In the cup.
He squeezes
the grape, put in the cup. And what happened?
Give it to Pharaoh.
Give it to Pharaoh. And what did Joseph say? Joseph said that you'll be taken back to your place. Thank you, Sister Maria. So, hand clap for Sister Maria. Welcome, Sister Maria. God bless you. Very good. So, after this, what Joseph said happened exactly the same thing. Amen. Now, notice, if one of these guys wasn't in the prison with Joseph, who could tell Pharaoh that there is a man in the prison who can interpret dreams? No one. Do you understand? So it was important for Joseph to be in the prison, isn't it? For him to get the connection to the king. Do you understand? So he gave the interpretation to the dream and he told that man, when you be restored to your position, please don't forget about me. Tell the king about me. And the Bible said that when the man went there, he forgot about Joseph. Amen. And after that, the king had a dream. Okay. What was the dream? And behold, there came out of the river seven well-fashioned kine and fat flesh, and they fed in a meadow. And behold, seven other kind came up after them out of the river, ill-favored and lean-fleshed, okay, and stood by the other kind upon the brink of the river. What happened after that? So those small cows, skinny cows, eating the fat ones. So what was the interpretation of the dream of Joseph? I know that you know the story. Who can tell me what Joseph said about this one? Yes, it's Erica.
That there was going to be famine and that they had to save food.
Yeah, for how long?
7 years.
What 7 years remind you?
Seven.
Thank you very much. Seven church ages. So after seven church ages, there the famine will be over. And after the seven church ages, there one must be Joseph to bring food, isn't it? For everyone, for Egyptian, and also for Israel. Are you familiar?
Yes.
But Abraham said that Jesus was the type of, Joseph was the type of
Jesus.
Praise God. Seven years. Here, famine will come. Before the famine, There will be 7 years of abundance. So much food. That means don't eat all the food. Because after 7 years, you are going to starve. So what you have to do, you keep some food for the bad period will come after. Amen? And 7 years of famine, okay? Which means 7 church ages. So Joseph was there storing food. You understand? Mm-hmm. And after 7 years of famine, Balaam said that there's going to be famine, not only in natural food, but of spiritual food as well. Amen. So during the 7 church ages, there wasn't food. There was only what Balaam called the denomination. And the denomination is the interpretation to the word of God, which is not correct. Amen. But for the last time after the 7 church ages, God must send Joseph with food. And if you read Barabbas' message called What Time Is It, Sir? He preached in 1962. God told him to store the food. Barabbas said that I start storing the food. He said, oh, when he had a dream, he said, oh, what is that? Is it about natural food or spiritual food? And Barabbas said that it was a spiritual food. That the reason you see today, we have the voice of God recordings. God told Barabbas to do it. Amen? Storing food. What was the food? The food was the sermon, Barabbas' sermon, spiritual food to the people. But at the end of the 7 church ages, there must be Joseph. Amen? Amen. Store food and to distribute to the people. Amen. And Balaam said, I will have a son. I'll call his name Joseph. Amen. So Balaam knew exactly what he was doing. Maybe in the message, we don't really understand Balaam. Balaam said, I'll have a son. I call his name Joseph. Why only Joseph? What happened? Sister Mina was pregnant and she had a baby and it was a baby girl. Amen? And Sister Mina could say, oh, Billy, maybe you misunderstood God. It's not a boy, she's a girl. We call her name Sarah. And one of the brother called her, was mocking Barabbas and said, oh, William Barabbas, did you mean Josephine? Amen. Did you mean Josephine? Barabbas said that that man was trying to mock the prophet. Do you know what happened to him? He died. Listen, a prophet is the mighty God on earth. Do you understand? You notice that when Saul, the king, went to the magician to call for Samuel. When Samuel was coming, what the magician said, she said, I can't see God coming up. Amen. She said that, I see God coming up. She didn't say, I see the prophet, I see God. A prophet is the God in your age. You understand? Also the messengers. When we are talking about Jesus Christ, in the age of Ephesus, Jesus' name was Paul. If you reject Paul, you reject Jesus. You can't say that, oh, I love Jesus, but I don't like Paul. There's no way. So and so, until the last age, but Abraham is Jesus Christ for our age. Do you understand? So if you reject William Branham, straight away you reject God. You reject Samuel, you reject And the brother said, "Do you mean Josephine?" He said, "I didn't say Josephine, I said Joseph." And the doctor called Brother Branham and said, "It was hard for your wife to have a child. I would advise you that not let her have a child anymore. Because the day she's going to have a child, she's going to die." Brother Branham said, "Thank you for your advice. But God told me that she's going to have a son, Joseph, and she's not going to die." The doctor said, "William Branham, I am the doctor, I know what I'm doing." But I want to say, "I respect that, but between you and God, I trust God more. I respect you, I respect your job, but God told me that I'm going to have a son. And Joseph had to come because God had a plan for someone to store the food. Not only for Gentiles, for Egyptians, but also for Israel." Are you with me? Jesus, Joseph, the type of Jesus Christ. It's so simple. But I want to say that if you want to understand the things of God, you must follow the types. Sister Mina fell pregnant again, and this time Joseph came. He said, "Oh, Joseph, my son, I was waiting for you for a long time." Amen. And Joseph went to school, he became a big boy. When he was, I think, 9 years old or 10, around 9 or 10, Brother Branham died. And Brother Roy Robertson took over. Took over on storing food. And in around 1985, something like that, then Brother Joseph took over. The voice of God recording. Until now, Brother Joseph, what he's doing is sharing food, distributing food to the people. And the food we take there, we go to that place, the voice of God recording. And when we put the tape, who's speaking there? Brother Branham. But it's God, the voice of God. Amen. So you can't say, "Oh, it's not the voice of God, it's the voice of Brother Branham." No, it's not Brother Branham speaking, it's the voice of God. Who is distributing food? Joseph. Amen. And Joseph was there to give food to Israel and Egyptians after 7 years of famine. Amen. So when you see Joseph appearing again with the food, distributing food, that means we are out of the 7 years of famine. Amen.
Amen.
Then Joseph is there to share food. That's the reason we have Joseph. And the infant and blah. So another dream was about, what was another dream? The second dream of the king? Yes, it was another dream.
The grain.
The grain, yeah. Yeah, it was the grain. Yeah, who can tell me? Sister Vicky. Yes, the skinny grain ate the fat grain. And when Joseph came, what Joseph said? Joseph said that both dreams, they are just telling the same thing. Both dreams was telling the same thing. So what we must do now, Joseph said, "Let us store food." Okay. Joseph giving the explanation to the dreams. And Joseph answered the Pharaoh saying, "It's not in me." Amen. God shall give Pharaoh an answer of peace. Not Joseph, But God, where was God? In Joseph. Amen. In the prison, where was God? In Joseph. So, the faith of Joseph was this. He knew that God was in him. Amen. Everything was happening to him, wasn't harming him, or wasn't bringing him down, or making him sad, because he knew that God is in me. Amen. You understand? So if I've got God, I can't be sick. I don't care. But I want to say that if God is with you, no one can harm you. Not even Satan. He said the only way for you to get in trouble, you must get out of God. You understand? That's why, guys, it's very dangerous for you to get out of God. I'll advise you this. If you want to get in trouble, yeah, get out of God. Then you found Satan straight away. He's going to deal with you. Do you understand? Satan is going to deal with you. Make sure that you're still living in the land. As we always singing, be careful with your eyes what you see. Be careful with your hand what you touch. Be careful with your feet where you go. Be careful with your mouth what you speak. And be careful with your brain what you think. But I want to say that think right. Okay? Think right. Watch right things. Be in the atmosphere of God. Then God will keep you. Trouble may come, but make sure that you've got God in your heart. As it was with Joseph. In the prison, Joseph went. God was in him. As I said last night, that everybody may be against me. Amen. And God is with me. I'm okay with that. I can be a good man on people's side. That, oh, but Eric is a good man. Oh, I like him. But when God says that you are bad, you're still bad. Amen. It's not about what people say it's about you, but it's about what God says. So my only aim is to seek for God's will. What God tells about me is what I'm looking for. I'm looking for the testimony of God, not the testimony of people. Amen. Do you understand? And this was the case with Joseph. Joseph knew that I've got God in my heart. I know that God is doing something, fixing something. Amen. Something's going to happen. Something good, of course. The Bible says that God has got good project for us, for you and me. Just be with God and you see His glory. I don't care how bad it looks today, but tomorrow, after tomorrow, it's going to be good because God is with you. Amen. Amen. Joseph had that kind of faith. In the prison, Joseph was there, quiet as can be. He came out, giving the interpretation to the dream. Amen. And after that, what happened? He became the second person. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, see, I have set thee over all the land of Egypt. And Pharaoh took off his ring from his hand and put it upon Joseph's hand. Amen. And arrayed him in vestures of linen and put a gold chain about his neck. That means that I give you my power. And my brother said that when Joseph was coming, everyone was bowed down and the trumpet was sound. Amen. That Joseph is coming. You see, the way up is down. If you go, you want to go up, go down first. Do you understand? Be humble. Humble yourself. Don't be showing off. I'm the best one. See, I've got the best shoes in the class. I've got the best computer. Me, I'm the best. Me. But what I'm saying is not good. Be humble. Humble yourself toward your brothers and sisters. But what I'm saying is never see yourself bigger than everyone. Never have that attitude. Be humble as you can be. And for sure, God is going to take you up. Now see, where Joseph came from the land of Israel, Joseph was just the last boy of the family. Amen. Just the baby of the family. Nothing. Amen. He was nothing, just a little baby of the family. And God had a plan for Joseph. The same as David as well. David was the last boy. Be careful with the last born of the family. Do you understand? God is always like that. God is taking the smallest one, is going to make him big. Never ever neglect anybody. Do you understand? Never ever neglect anybody. So you must respect everyone. Joseph was the baby of the family, but it was taken. He was betrayed by his brethren. He was sold to those Ishmaelites. He was taken to Egypt. He was put in prison. And after prison, Joseph now went to the top of Egypt. That was the plan of God. And the plan of God was also to take them in slavery. Do you understand? Amen. My Bible said that the victory is to know what is in God's mind. Do you understand? The word of God, the message of Barabara is just to show us what is God thinking. So because if you go out of God's thinking, amen, that's what we call sin. That's the reason God sent the prophet with his own thinking to tell us what God's plan was. And now we see that Joseph now reaching the top of Egypt, and the plan of God was fulfilled for Joseph. From there now, his family must come back after 7 years to meet their brother. And they forgot about him, do you understand? They forgot about Jesus. Israel doesn't know who Jesus is. The only thing Israel knows about Jesus is that he's going to deserve the thought of the heart of the people. But they don't know anything about his face. And when Joseph went to Egypt, even his name was changed. Do you know that? Do you know what was his name? He got a new name in Egypt. What was it? What?
Zaphnath-Paneah.
He changed his name. Do you understand? When he went to Egypt. Joseph is the type of Jesus. Amen. So that means that when Jesus, are you with me? Are you with me? That means that when Jesus will come to this side again, he changed also his name. Amen.
Egyptian's name.
He took the name of Egyptian. He took a wife of Egyptian.
Yes, sir.
And he had two sons, half Israel, half Egyptian. The names was Ephraim and Manasseh. Both of them, Gentile and Israelite. It's
the same thing.
And those two children was taken in the family of Jacob. Do you understand? And the wife of Joseph became a part of the family.
Yes, sir.
And they all made one family. Joseph meeting his brethren. Amen. So when Joseph met with his brethren, Joseph took everybody together. Gentiles and Israel becoming one family. When they are going to meet Joseph. Amen.
Amen.
So I'll stop here now. Next time we see Joseph meeting his brethren. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Let us sing glory to his name.
Thank you.
creation. Thank you for choosing us as your children, Father. And in this time, Lord, we commit again ourselves to you. For this wonderful time we had, Lord, let this one, this word of prophecy, Lord, come down in our hearts, Father. Let it, Lord, become one to us. Give us, Lord, that right, correct attitude, Lord, toward our brothers and sisters, Lord. And give us, Lord, that positive attitude to all everything, Lord, can happen to us in our life. We know that, Lord Jesus Christ, that always you are there as you was with Joseph. Thank you, Lord, for time, for this time, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for speaking to us. As we commit ourselves to you, we commit our meeting in our hands. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. Amen. God bless you. We go for 5 minutes, then come back. So if you, when you say 5 minutes, you come back by yourself. I don't have to call you. Okay? 5 minutes. Amen. God bless you.